harness road race begins a little more than 10 minutes from now. It's taking place. You can see all the runners lining up right on Broad Street and Elm, right around that area. It's going to be a great day. The parade kicks off at 11:30, makes it down here in the center of town about noon. It's going to be a great day, everybody. Expect a big crowd. And once again, welcome to the Windsor JC's 2019 Shad Derby Day Festival here in Windsor.
Space in between them.
I got it.
Don't forget the frap.
Yeah.
Shut up.
Don't you know, you did a decent job on
it. You can have a many color you like.
And welcome to the 2019 Shad Derby Parade here on an absolutely perfect day here in beautiful downtown Windsor. You can see from a distance the parade is making its way past the library and on its way over here. We remind you, of course, as you know, there's a lot of activity that's going to take place on the street, so please be careful. Please don't be crossing in front of people. All the normal parade etiquette you should be familiar with by this point. And of course, a little bit later, we have those little motorcycles coming, and if your toes are out a little farther than they should be, you never know what's going to happen. So anyways, everybody think safety. Safety first, ladies and gentlemen. And we'll all have a good time. The Windsor JC's have clearly made this a great parade. I thumbed through all the information of all the different groups participating in this, and this is going to be a good one. And of course, don't forget, after the parade, all of the vendors are still here. Here's the Lions Club right in back of me, Kiwanis Club, all of our civic groups. This is the event where they make the most money to help Windsor, to help the people in Windsor with various things, scholarships, all kinds of activities that they do, but this is what they do to raise the most money. So don't forget to support all of our civic groups here today and all of our other groups as well. Of course, while we're waiting, I mentioned it a little bit earlier, but starting at 1 o'clock, Buffalo Wild Wings is here. They're going to have their wing eating competition taking place right in front of the town hall. That's going to be at 1 o'clock and I believe 2 o'clock. So two competitions there. You can sign up for that. And then, of course, in the beer garden, we have Dave Mack performing at 1 o'clock. And then after that, Windsor Zone. I'm going to call him a classic, ladies and gentlemen. Gene Donaldson and the Stingrays will be performing in the beer garden. Always a great show. We have him back for the summer concerts here during the summer. And in fact, he'll be playing June 27th right on the town green in our summer concert series all summer long on the Thursday nights. Gene Donaldson performs in the beer garden at 2:30. And it looks as if we see some movement at this point. Once again, I'd like to welcome you, and the Windsor JCs welcome you to the 2019 Shad Derby Parade and Festival. Thank you to all of this year's participants. We hope that you enjoy today's parade and festivities on the green. The JCs support community organizations in town, such as the Windsor High Scholarship Program, Team Paragon Robotics Club, Willa, which is the Windsor Independent Living Association, and Challenger Basketball. The Windsor JCs believe that service to humanity is the best work of life. The Windsor JCs, Shad Derby Parade. All right, and approaching the reviewing stand is the Windsor Shadmobile. Once again, the Shadmobile is making an appearance slowly in the Shad Derby Parade, originally built by the Windsor High School Auto Club and salvaged by former Windsor High Auto Club president Marissa Demkowski. Since being salvaged, Chuck Arasati, Mike and Tom Demkowski, Corey Morin have maintained the Shadmobile to keep the tradition alive and swimming. Pulling the Shadmobile, this is Mr. Mike Bernard with his farm all each tractor, the Windsor Shadmobile. Once again, Windsor Shadmobile. And now it is time for the Shad Derby Grand Marshal, Mr. Robert Ganji. The Windsor JCs announced Dr. Robert Ganji as this year's Shad Derby Parade Grand Marshal. Dr. Ganji, born in Hartford, spent his education years in Cleveland, Ohio, St. Ignatius High School, and John Carroll University, which laid the foundation for his dental education from East Western Reserve University. Upon completion of his doctorate in dental surgery, Dr. Ganji served as a dentist in the U.S. Coast Guard. Finally, he returned to CWRU to specialize in orthodontics, allowing him to pursue a true passion, bringing beautiful smiles to children and adults alike. In 1973, Dr. Ganji and his wife Valerie moved to Windsor. Here he built his practice. To this day, allows him a rewarding career and lifelong friends. Congratulations, Dr. Ganji. The 2019 Shad Derby Grand Marshal. Dr. Ganji has devoted much of his free time serving the community. He's had the privilege of serving as director and president of the Windsor JCs, through which he has received many honors. This includes JC of the Year, the Peak Man Certificate, and recognition as one of the 5 outstanding JCs in Connecticut for distinguished service to his community. As the JC's representative on the Shad Fest Bureau, Dr. Ganji was further honored by the opportunity to serve as president through co-chairing the Shad Derby in 1982, 88, 2008, as well as his continued involvement today. Ladies and gentlemen, the Windsor Fife and Drum Corps, established in January of 1985. It performed in New York, Virginia, Washington, D.C., Rhode Island, Vermont, and Western Massachusetts, several times at Disney World. Over the years, it's won many competitions, including Connecticut, Massachusetts, and the Valley of European Championships. Windsor Fife and Drum Corps. It is the Windsor High School Air Force Junior ROTC group. They are in their fourth year at Windsor High School, developing citizens of character dedicated to serving their nation and community. The cadet group commander is Cadet Major Jonathan Schoenfeld. Deputy commander, Cadet Captain Morgan B. Stevens. And here are our local representatives. Here's Jane Garibay, ladies and gentlemen. Brandon McGee. And members of our town council, Jody Terranova, Joe McCollum, members of our Board of Education, Ron Orville, Brian Bosch, members of our town council, Don Jepson is here, Kenny Wilkos is here, from the Board of Education, David Fury, Vice President of the Board of Ed. Oh, and here, oh, ladies and gentlemen, I have to do this every year. He has been mayor in this town longer than any other mayor in the 385-year history of the town. Ladies and gentlemen, the mayor of the town of Windsor, Mr. Donald Prince. And Emily Thompson is here. She is our festival chair. Emily Thompson is a lifelong Windsor resident, having gone through the public school system, ultimately graduating from the Metropolitan Learning Center in Bloomfield. Her interest in Shad Derby started at an early age, joining her father, Glenn Thompson, in many of the Shad Derby fishing events. As a longtime member of the Rod and Gun Club, her official duties started last year as a member of the Queen's Committee, where she became very interested in duties and responsibilities of the Shad Derby Chair. Lon Felton. Here we go. Windsor excavator and artist Lon Felton is well known for his eccentric art creations. There he is driving. You're driving? Why are you driving? Change is inevitable, get used to it. Mike's Auto and Towing? Oh. He's yelling at me, but that's nothing new. This Model T Ford was brought new from the Windsor garage in 1915 by Charles Sackett, a longtime resident of Windsor. Lon Felton, ladies and gentlemen. And up next is the first robotics competition team, Team Paragon 571, and the first Tech Challenge team, Blazing Spirits. They're located in Windsor, right here in Windsor, comprised of team students from Windsor and surrounding areas. There's one very tall member of the Team Paragon. Their mission is to provide the opportunity for young minds to channel their creative energy in a safe environment that promotes learning towards disciplines of science, technology, engineering, and math. That would be STEM. Everybody's heard of STEM. As well as presenting these young minds with problems and difficult situations that require exploration, aptitude, skill, and limitations. The team always welcomes new members. Team Paragon and the Blazing Spirits. Coming up next, it's the Windsor High School Band. Windsor High Warrior Band, under the direction of Ms. Rebecca Bernardo since 2017. Drum major Ben Levesque and Hannah O'Connor. You can join them at their Circuit Concert on May 23rd at 7 p.m. at Windsor High School. Take a listen. Equestrian education and support programs help to improve the lives of all participants, with most continuing on to higher education and college. Thank you very much, Ebony Horsewomen. Group consists of members of our Junior Mounted Patrol, Young Ladies Dressage Team, Ebony Horsewomen staff and alumni. Thank you all for coming. There are some classic cars here at the Shad Derby Parade. 1968 Cadillac. Miss Town Real Estate. Now we are moving into our Queen's Convertibles, ladies and gentlemen. Kicking it off, this is Candace Benazowitz, First Town Realty Real Estate. Candace enjoys baking, raising animals, hiking, and bow hunting. She's been the president of the Our Farms 4-H Club for 5 years, is a member of the Latin Honor Society. Candace will be attending UConn in the fall to study biology. Candace Benazowitz. Up next is Miss Rice Hardware, Haley Place. Haley is a Cadet Lieutenant Colonel of the Air Force Junior ROTC program at the Windsor High School. She's captain of the swim and dive team and plays on the Windsor High softball team. She will be joining the Air Force National Guard and will be attending UConn to study communication disorders in the fall. Haley Place. Miss Rice Hardware. Up next, Serena Rudman, Miss Ashley's Distinctive Jewelry and Gifts. She's a member of the National Honor Society, is a senior advisor leader, and plays on the varsity girls tennis team at Windsor High School. Serena will be attending Southern Connecticut State University to study communication disorders. Once again, Serena Rudman. Up next, Elena Anderson, Dr. Robert Ganji, Orthodontics. Elena plays soccer, basketball, swimming, and is captain of the golf at Loomis Chafee School. She's a member of the Loomis Chafee Cum Laude Society and a National Hispanic Scholar. Elena will be majoring in engineering and playing golf at the Harvey Mudd College next year. Elena Anderson, Miss Dr. Robert Ganji. Up next is Mr. Hairdresser on Fire, Aaron Peterson. Aaron is a leadership council member, choir class president, Windsor High varsity swim team captain, Windsor High School varsity lacrosse captain, Windsor High cheerleader. He's a member of the Young Men's Leadership Academy and senior NCCJ Anytown counselor. He's been in Windsor Youth Theater for 4 years while being a youth member of the NCCJ Board of Directors. He receives the Superintendent Leadership Award. Aaron's in the Action Club and Helping Hands Club. He's a senior advisor leader as well as student ambassador. My goodness. Aaron Peterson, Mr. Hairdresser on Fire. And he hopes to attend Pace University in the fall to study musical theater. And now, ladies and gentlemen, the Queen and her court. Started off with Sarah Latimer, Miss Noon's Quality Plumbing and Heating, is the Mary Ellen Messina and Vincent Scully Memorial Award winner. Sarah is a member of the National Honor Society, the treasurer of the French Honor Society, a council member of the class of 2019, and prides herself on her community service activities. Sarah is attending Pennsylvania State University in the fall to study nursing and psychology. Grace Stouch is Miss Windsor Federal Savings and the 2019 Second Princess. Grace is president of the Spanish Honor Society and a member of the National Honor Society, runs cross country, and is the captain of the Windsor High indoor and outdoor track teams. Grace will be attending University of Connecticut in the fall. Paige Simons, Miss Dom's Broad Street Eatery, is the 2019 First Princess. Paige is a member of the Rio Kappa National Honor Society and a member of the Educators Rising Club and Teachers Assistant. Paige will be attending Rhode Island College studying a secondary education and mathematics and will be competing in swimming and diving. Molly Shannon, Miss Windsor JC, is Miss Congeniality and the 2019 Princess Royale. Molly is a member of the National Honor Society and is Activities Coordinator for the Social Studies Honor Society. She's a Senior Event Editor for the School Yearbook and Captain of the Girls Lacrosse Team at Windsor High. Molly will be attending the College of St. Rose, where she will study communications and psychology and play lacrosse. Madeline Morin Vial, Miss Exchange Club of Windsor, is the 2019 Shad Derby Queen. Madeline enjoys ice dancing, writing, traveling, and spending time with her friends. She is in the National Honor Society. Oh, she's the president of the National Honor Society. Class valedictorian and a three-time Poetry Out Loud school champion. Maddie will be attending UConn in the fall to study English. Ladies and gentlemen, the 2019 Shad Derby Queen, Madeline Morin. Wow. Congratulations to all of the candidates, everybody, and the queen and her court. All right, coming up next is Grace Church. Grace Episcopal Church, located right here on the green. Right out here on the green. Please come by anytime to share in the fellowship and friendship. Their Shad is King of Fishes. He was made by the parishioners of Grace Church just for the parade.
Plenty of seats, no waiting. Good for the heart, good for the soul.
There we go. Grace Church, ladies and gentlemen. Look at this. Look at who's in there. This is fishing. Shad Derby. Got it. Let's figure that out.
You'll learn eventually.
There's somebody in there? Huh. I don't know who that is. Up next, it is the Windsor Water Rats. Express Swim Team. Windsor Water Rats is a competitive swim team that has deep roots in Windsor. For over 50 years, the Windsor Water Rats have offered recreational and USA swimming for families in Windsor, children ages 5 to 18. Water Rats is proud of their Windsor heritage, and the team is growing stronger and stronger each season. Tryouts for the 2019 summer season will be held at the high school pool May 21st and 23rd. Come join the team and be part of this amazing group of dedicated athletes and families, the Windsor Water Rats, ladies and gentlemen. Up next is the Windsor Soccer Club. As you can see, they continue to thrive here in 2019, founded in 1982. It's a nonprofit organization that begins working with children at the age of 4 years old. On Saturday mornings, all the way up through high school, the club strives to not only build a strong soccer program, but to teach children individual responsibility, sportsmanship, teamwork, and a strong work ethic. The Windsor Travel Team program is the largest it's been in years, with seven teams, both boys and girls, from 9 to 14. So far this spring, the teams have a combined record of 22-6-1. That is pretty good, I would say. Way to go, Windsor Soccer Club. It's the Connecticut Patriots Fife and Drum Corps. The Connecticut Patriots are senior Fife and Drum Corps, enjoys traveling all over the East Coast and Europe. The Corps plays a combination of traditional and contemporary pieces. August 5th through the 9th. See you right there on the banner. Christ Proclamation Church, ladies and gentlemen. Just up the street, 100 Addison Road. What a great looking float. Up next, the John F. Kennedy School K Kids. The John F. Kennedy K Kids are made up of 52 fourth and fifth graders who have a passion for helping others by giving back to the community. They have participated in several community service projects, such as collecting caps, mittens, and scarves for women and children, Christmas caroling at Kimberly Hall, and some of our K Kids have served as ambassadors at Junior Achievement's 14th Annual Partners in Achievement Breakfast. Up next is the First Town Veterinary Science 4-H Club. The First Town Veterinary Science 4-H Club is proudly advised by Dr. Larry Pennington, Rebecca Massey, and Leah Leach. The club is Windsor-based and is 50 kids strong, ranging from ages 7 to 18. We're all passionate and dedicated to animals. New curriculum is taught at every meeting and through educational field trips, making the 4-H projects, and doing great community service, the kids are learning wonderful skills. They are our future. Today, they may be 4-H'ers, but tomorrow, they will be our veterinarians. Oh, there he is. Here he is, ladies and gentlemen, Dr. Larry Pennington. You got the special seat, right?
Yeah, that's right. Give me a four!
Thank you, First Town Veterinary Science 4-H Club. Up next, Paquonic School. The school in which I happen to be an alumni of. I am not going to tell you the year. Paquonic School is a pre-K to second grade elementary school led by Principal Tracy Peterson. That school is a diverse school community where students are prepared to be productive citizens in a global society. We are committed to providing students with a first-class education that prepares students with a solid foundation in reading, writing, social studies, science, and mathematics. Paquonic School. Thank you all for coming. A big crowd from Paquonic School today. Up next is the Connecticut Vietnam Veterans of America, Chapter 120. Never again will one generation of veterans abandon another. Thank you all for your service, ladies and gentlemen. Once again, the Connecticut Vietnam Veterans of America, Chapter 120. Up next is the Windsor Junior Women's Club. The Windsor Junior Women's Club is an all-volunteer nonprofit organization proud to be celebrating its 50th year. The Windsor Junior Women's Club supports Windsor citizens, Windsor charities, and Windsor schools through fundraising and service, as well as other Connecticut charities through its parent organization, the Connecticut Junior Women's Club. In addition to these efforts, as a long-standing member of the Shad Fest Bureau, the Windsor Junior Women's Club has the pleasure of hosting the annual Shad Derby Coronation Ball. The Windsor Junior Women's Club, ladies and gentlemen. Up next is the Windsor Little League. Baseball and softball are here today, offering levels of play for children from 5 to 12 years old. Little League and Senior Junior Little League for players 13 to 15 for softball and baseball. The Windsor Little League is an organization that helps to instill a sense of sportsmanship and community in its players. Come out to a game one of these days over at Fitchfield or Welch Park. Windsor Little League, baseball and softball. Wow. This is like a third of the parade. kids are still in the parade, but they're kind of quiet. Why are you so quiet? I knew that would work. Collection of people from the Windsor Little League. Thank you all for coming. Up next is Cub Scout Pack 149. They're an active, award-winning pack that meets every Friday at Trinity United Methodist Church. They strive to teach lifelong skills and qualities through strong programming and fun activities such as model rocketry, pinewood derby races, camping, hiking, and many more. You can go to pack149.com. After that, followed by Cub Scout Pack 203. There they are. Welcome boys entering kindergarten through grade 5.
And girls!
And girls!
And girls.
Oh, that's right too. Scouts in Pack 203 know how to have fun with a purpose. Rocket into scouting today with Pack 203. And followed by Girl Scout Troop 10169. Girl Scout Troop, Girl Scouting girls of courage, confidence, and character who make the world a better place. Daisy Troop 10169, made up of kindergarten and first graders, learning to live by the Girl Scout law. And this looks like Oliver Ellsworth to me. Oliver Ellsworth, ladies and gentlemen. Oliver Ellsworth Huskies are proud students and staff who participate safely, acts with kindness, and works with respect for student success. Oliver Ellsworth is a preschool to grade 2 elementary school of stupendous students. Everybody's stupendous here, right? Yes, okay. If your child will be 5 by January 1st, 2020, please register your child for kindergarten and join the wonderful Windsor Public Schools. Oliver Ellsworth, ladies and gentlemen. Go to HartfordWolfpack.com. Thank you, Sonar, for being at this year's parade. Up next, Clover Street. Kids, a community service school made up of 35 fifth graders from Clover Street School. They're involved in activities and programs that provide support to Clover, Windsor, and other cities and towns in Connecticut, and even other parts of the world. For the past several years, they've written letters and made cards each month for several troop members who are serving overseas. This year, we held a variety of fundraisers, filled a canoe with canned goods for the Windsor Food Bank, collected hats and mittens during the winter months for people in need, and held a family movie night where they raised $700 for Operation Fuel, ladies and gentlemen. Collaborated with the Windsor Kiwanis, the Greater Hartford JCs, and the Town of Windsor on multiple projects over many years. During the meetings, they focus on different ways to help our community and how to continue to help others through giving. We build all things. Ladies and gentlemen, Clover Street School, K-Kids. Thank you for being here today. There you go, Clover Street, kids. And coming up next, Sage Park Middle School. Home of the proud Chargers. Sage Park is a community of learners for those who encourage all students and opportunities for academic, social, and emotional growth. Up next is Windsor Climate Action. There are two Made in America electric automobiles. Windsor Climate Action sponsors the Chevy Bolt and Tesla Model T. Windsor Climate Action is a citizen action group concerned about global warming and is looking for Connecticut's first town to take the lead within state and local solutions to climate change. For more information, they are on the green today with their booth. Go ahead and visit them. Windsor Climate Action. All right, remember how I said earlier, keep your feet back. This is why, ladies and gentlemen. Here they are, the State Shrine Cycle Unit. Always a great presentation by this group here at the Shad Derby Parade. They ride so kids can walk. Big Shrine Soccer Unit. To give you a little background about the Shriners, in 1922, the Shriners founded the first Shriners Hospital for Children in Shreveport, Louisiana. Since then, this unique group has grown to an extraordinary health system with 22 facilities in the United States, Canada, and Mexico. Shriners Hospitals for Children is changing lives every day through innovative pediatric specialty care, world-class research, and outstanding medical education. Their hospitals provide advanced care for children with orthopedic conditions, burns, spinal cord injuries, and stress and trauma. Ladies and gentlemen, the Shriners! Oh no, these are the false alarmers. There's a new antique fire truck. Thank you, gentlemen.
Hey, gentlemen, I don't know about that.
Well, we use that term loosely. Once again, the Shriners False Alarmers, based out of Newington, Connecticut. Oh, I love these cars. I don't know how they do this. This is the Motor Patrol, the State Shrine Motor Patrol, founded in 1955. The Motor Patrol participates in parades to bring awareness of the Shriners and the Shriners Hospitals that they support. The little Jeeps are many turned up with us in a 1941 Jeep. They were handmade by the original members between 1955 and 1961. The State Shrine Motor Patrol. And coming up next, it's the State Shriners Brass Band. Also based out of Newington, they were formed in 1899, making it the oldest continually formed and performing Shriners band in the world. And there they are on their bandwagon. Again, the State Shriners Brass Band. And the Shriners continue with the Funsters. That car, actually, that is their paddy wagon. It is a 1927 Ford Model T truck. And the cops, the clowns, act as Keystone Cops. There they go. Causing many, many smiles and lots of laughter. The St. Shine Funsters, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you for being here every year at the Shad Derby Parade. St. Shine Funsters, ladies and gentlemen, out of Newington. Thank you, everybody. Up next is Praise, Power, and Prayer Christian School. They have been long-standing members of the Windsor community, serving students from the greater Hartford area for over 30 years. They're located at 209 Kennedy Road. Praise, Power, and Prayer Christian School provides a quality education, small class sizes, and biblical teaching in a safe, nurturing environment. Enrollment is now open for kindergarten through 12th grade. For the upcoming school year, as well as their 8-week world travel theme summer program beginning June 24th, Praise, Power, and Prayer Christian Church.
It's gonna go viral.
In school. Cool, I'm sorry. Once again, a little gap in the parade, just to make mention. We have plenty of activities taking place after the parade. Of course, Buffalo Wild Wings has their wing eating competition right in front of the town hall. That'll take place at 1 o'clock and 2 o'clock in the beer garden. Mr. Gene Donaldson and the Stingrays will be performing over in the beer garden at 2:30. And then, of course, the event closes at 4 o'clock, so we've got plenty of time to visit all the various civic groups and vendors here on the town green on an absolutely great day at the 2019 Shad Derby Day. And coming up here is the Lawrence Martial Arts Center. The Larry's Martial Arts Center has been serving the community of Windsor for over 25 years. Their goal is to help every individual they teach reaching their personal goals, realize their full potential, and achieve black belt excellence. Ladies and gentlemen, the Larry's Martial Arts Center. Once again, here's more of the Larry's Martial Arts Center. The Larry's Martial Arts Center, ladies and gentlemen. Alright, after a little break, coming up here is Dance Praise Dance Studio. Founded in 2006, they offer our Windsor community the ultimate dance experience. Offer a family-oriented, safe, fun, and positive learning environment for their students. Provide a solid foundation for building strength, flexibility, coordination, and balance. Here it is, Dance Praise Dance Studios out of Enfield and Windsor. In fact, the Windsor location is, oh, you can just walk right through it. It's right at the end of the green over here. Dance Praise Dance Studios. Dance Praise Dance Studios. Making their first appearance here at the Windsor Shad Derby. And of course, you know the Windsor Police Cadets are here as well. They are a local-run youth organization run by Sergeant Petkus, Officer Alberti, other officers and civilian advisors. The cadets have won the best overall post in 3 years, actually 3 years in a row at the NERLEAA. Wow, that's a long acronym. Police Cadet Station Day Competition. Congratulate them, the police cadets, and all the work that they do right here in our community. And now we move on, ladies and gentlemen, the Windsor Fire Department. Kicking it off with Pequannock, ladies and gentlemen. The Windsor Volunteer Fire Department is one of Connecticut's oldest all-volunteer fire departments, led by Chief Bill Lewis and staffed with almost 100 town residents who volunteer their time to ensure the safety of the town's citizen and property. They are always looking for new members, and this is your chance to give back to the community. The fire department is committed to training and education and needs men and women ages 18 and up to keep the fire department responsive. It is without question the fine work these individuals do in this community 24 hours a day. All volunteer, ladies and gentlemen. Once again, the Windsor Fire Department, ladies and gentlemen, and all the good work they do in our community. All four individual areas covered. We have Wilson, we have Pequannock, there's Windsor Center right here. All of these people are volunteers in our community. Something happens at 3 in the morning, they are there. At Hayden Station this year, but that's okay. Pequannock is here as well. Pequannock Firehouse. And the members of the Pequannock Fire Department and all of our volunteers here serving you 24 hours a day. The Windsor Volunteer Fire Department. Thank you all. Ladies and gentlemen. Ladies and gentlemen, that is it. That is our 2019 Windsor Shad Derby Day Parade. Thank you all for attending. We have got an entire afternoon of fun activities, different things going on here in the green. Close at 4, so there's all kinds of time to get around and take a look at what all of our groups and civic organizations have to offer you today. Make sure you visit them. Once again, as I mentioned earlier, this is where they raise most of the money for their year-long events that take place with the various civic groups. So now is the time to help these groups out. And as I mentioned before, we've got Gene Donaldson and the Stingrays, the Buffalo Wild Wings, meat eating competition coming up, and many other events right here at the 2019 Shad Derby Day Festival. And once again, our Grand Marshal, Dr. Robert Ganju, joining me up here on the reviewing stand. Thank you.
Thank you.
For that and other reasons, but...
You guys bring some macaroni.
Looks like 10 rings on each
plate.
Kendall. Are you ready? Okay, sizzle.
All right. At this point, can I have everybody standing in front to take 3 or 4 steps back so they give them a little bit of room? Because you never know what's going to happen here. Trust me, we've done this a number of years, and trust me, anything can happen with this. You may not be pretty.
Oh, it'll be pretty. Yeah. It'll be pretty.
Oh, I hope so.
I need one
question. What are we doing? We have a few more on the end.
I can tell from here. I'm like 3 feet away, and I can tell from here these are hot ladies, ladies and gentlemen. And in case you didn't know, the winner gets a gift certificate, a gift card shipped from Buffalo Wild Wings.
An attendee.
Okay,
I am doing it.
We're here for you, coach.
All right, we're actually going to set a timer this year. So there is a time limit to this event. I think we have the last plate coming over.
What's the time limit?
6 minutes.
Easy.
Or the first one done.
How close is this plate? Are you serious?
No.
6 minutes on the pen?
Normally it's right from the top.
Listen, I think it's easy.
All right, somebody here brought a couple bottles of water. Well, that's
yeah, get
not
out
allowed
of here.
Whatsoever.
Cheater! Cheater!
We cannot have water here.
Kendall, this is yours!
Cheater!
This is
Kendall. Kendall, get this.
Cheater! All right.
They're Kendall. No, seriously. All
right.
Kendall's worried about you.
She saw you sweat.
All right, everybody knows the rules here. You basically have 10 wings to eat. These are boneless wings from Buffalo Wild Wings. You have to eat each and every single one of them. We've had people in the past just try to shove all 10 in your mouth. Doesn't work. Must be gone. So, are we ready to begin? All right. All right, 6 minute maximum here. Unless you finish first, I think we're ready. Here we go, ladies and gentlemen. Let's do it from 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go. Here we go. 10 wings, ladies and gentlemen. 10 wings they have to eat. These are the hot ones on the scale from 1 to 5. Talking about an 8 here on hotness scale. Some people are using a fork, some people are using their fingers. I don't think there's any strategy either way. All right, we've got a few people left. All right, down 3 over here. Actually, doing very well on this end of the table. 5, 6, 5 left. Don't laugh. All right. I expect for this half of the table to be a little bit bigger eaters here.
Oh, that
guy's close. I gotta tell you, the women on this side are doing real well. And again, we have somebody here on the opposite side putting down the last 2. And once again, you can put it in your mouth. Everybody can he is still chewing. He is not a winner yet. It's all got to go down, ladies and gentlemen. We've got 3 over there. I think we have a winner right here. Congratulations. Wow.
Congratulations. $20 to Buffalo Wild Wings. There great job, guys. Congrats.
All right. Congratulations to our winner. And, well, everybody. Nothing is stopping you from finishing your plate. Feel free. And then we have another competition at 2 o'clock. Oh, sorry. All right.
Thank you all for participating in the Buffalo Wild Wings wing eating competition. We'll have another one at 2 o'clock.
Let's go!
That's it, George!
No, that's 10. 11. We have 11 competitors. There's one more spot available. Anyone? Any takers? We have somebody waiting over here in the back. Right over here. Come on over.
Come on in. Come on. Want to make some work?
Okay, unlike the first competition, they switched it around, so these are the very mild wings.
No.
So it's going to be very easy.
Fire. What?
Thought I'd try. Okay, no. These are just the opposite. These are the hottest wings possible. I got the sun coming this way and the winds this way. I'm not sure which is hotter.
Don't let it touch your
while we're getting the last two plates ready, just explain the rules as we have done in the past, I don't know how many years, we've probably been doing this for about 5 years. You have 10 boneless wings on your plate in front of you. In order to win this competition, they all have to be eaten and swallowed. Everything. You have to have a clean plate and nothing in your mouth. There'll be inspectors. I don't know who's going to do that.
Can we stand up?
And there's, I suppose you could stand up, sure. I don't know if that would make a difference. Probably wouldn't. I wouldn't think. It's a different part of the body doing things, so I would think it wouldn't make a difference, but whatever.
You guys ready for punishment?
No.
And once again, they all have to be down. We've had people in the past just take all 10, shove them in their mouth, and figure they were done, and it's like, no.
Doc will give you $5.
I'll
give you $5. Any one of you can beat us.
All right, now there's even a wagering comment taking place on one side of the table to the other. All I'm saying is we better make Windsor Public Works proud. That's all I'm saying right here.
Windsor Little League
is right here. All right. Are we ready to begin this competition? Second round from Buffalo Wild Wings. On your mark. Does everyone understand the rules, first off? Okay, just making sure. I did say Windsor Public Works. All right, never mind. All right, here we go, ladies and gentlemen. On your mark, get set, go! There we go, all 10 wings have to go down in order to win. Winner gets a gift certificate, by the way, from Buffalo Wild Wings. They do this every year, we love having this competition here. Everybody knows Buffalo Wild Wings right up the street, Paquonic Avenue, right by the highway. They do this every year for us. It's a great competition here at the Shad Derby. Let's see how things are going. Yeah, he's doing pretty well. 5-4 remaining over here. There's our leader right in the center with 4. I don't know what strategy is going on right now. How does this help? I don't know what's going on. All right, what are we doing? 5 minutes remaining. We've got four over here doing pretty well. Three over here doing pretty well. This gentleman here is just relaxing, taking it easy. There's no need to hurry. Enjoy the day. Oh, how are we doing over here? Look at this three. We've got four, three over here. We're down to two. It is getting very close, ladies and gentlemen. Two. He's going for one. Face is turning a little red now. Everybody doing all right? Oh, we have two here. We've got a little competition going right over here. Two and one. Three in the center. Three, three. One and one. Oh, here we go. We have nothing on the plate. When it's gone, here we go. And are we done? That is an empty mouth, ladies and gentlemen. We have a winner. Wow. Congratulations to everybody. And something, to be quite honest, I would never do, but a great job. Monday morning at work, you'll have something to brag about.
Okay. control it. We don't want any broken bones.
Oh,
yeah. Chandra, do you? Oh, she's recording it too. Everybody record. Somebody's got to have a good one. I just stink at it, so.
Thank you.
kick my feet up, stare at the fair. Pick the TV on and throw my hands in my pants. Nobody's gonna tell me I can't. I'll be lying in my class, chilling with my snuggie. Pick on every visa that can show me how to duggy. Cause in my castle, I'm the freaking boy.
Time. Thank you.
where the water tastes like wine. Yeah, going where the water tastes like wine. Ooh, going where the water tastes like wine. Says sunshine, I wanna be this away. So I'm going down the road.
Richard in the monitor mix? That'd be great. Little, yeah, just a little more drums. Really? No, in the monitor mix, yeah. Just a little bit. Yes, yeah, exactly.
Better gypsy, barroom queen,
All right, let's bring Georgie up here. Big George, do that. Come on, man. Let's do a couple blues tunes.
Mom! Judy!
Bring George up.
How about a Virginia Donaldson, everybody?
You can still dance up here, so I'm trying to get this.
Gotta get that high end out, man. Take the high end out. Now, just take the high end out a little bit. Oh, beautiful day, huh? I'm gonna do some slip hop on for you. We'll be right back.
and you shout on the bottom. The shout beat us by shout to the top. Shout, we're gonna shout to the top. Shout, I'm gonna shout to the top. We're gonna shout.